Better than that, God is worthy to be praised. Amen. Come on, just for a few seconds, with the fruit of your lips, just begin to bless the Lord in this place. For the Bible declares that I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast unto the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Come on, oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is worthy to be praised. So God, we come before you this morning. We come first of all just to say thank you. God, we thank you, oh God, just for waking us up this morning, oh God. We thank you for another chance and another opportunity to come into your house this morning. And before we ask you for anything, we ask that you forgive us of our sins, yes, and God, our shortcomings. Yes, God. Oh, God, sanctify us and purify us. Make us holy. Let our worship and our praise be acceptable before you, oh, God. If there's anything that's in us that's not pleasing, oh, God, we ask that you take it out right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we come today just to give you glory. We come to give you honor, and we come to give you praise because you've been so good to us, and for that we say thank you. You've been merciful, and for that we say thank you. You've been kind, and for that we say thank you. You've opened doors, and for that we say thank you. You made ways, and for that we say thank you. You kept us and protected us, and for that we say thank you. Oh God, we can't thank you for all that you've done, and God, we ask that you manifest your glory in this place on today. Send your Shekinah glory in this house, oh God. Oh God, move like never before, oh God. Do a new thing in this place, oh God. Rain down in this place, oh God. Send your presence in this place, oh God. Send your anointing in this place, oh God. Because it's the anointing that destroys every yoke. And we ask that you destroy the yoke of bondage right now, oh God. Destroy the yoke of depression right now, oh God. Destroy the yoke of sickness and disease right now, oh God. Oh, we claim it to be so. We ask that you touch the man of God that will declare your word. Oh God, strengthen him even right now, oh God. Open up our ears that we may hear from you. Oh God, we're ready to receive. And we give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, put your hands together. We come to give our God praise. Hallelujah.
Oh, we'll see.
God, and he is greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your name, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. We bless you, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the beauty of his holiness. Hallelujah. We just want to say, Lord, you're welcome in this place. Not so much the building, but the building. You're welcome in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and welcome the Spirit of the Lord in. Hallelujah. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Have your way. Can we lift that today? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. As we go, to the Lord our God before his throne of mercy and grace. Hallelujah, Jesus. We ask God to have his way in our lives. Hallelujah. Those who are heavy burdened, come. Come. Lay all your cares at his feet. Hallelujah, Jesus. We ask, oh God, to have your way. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you once again. Thank you once again for allowing us to be in your presence, oh God. Lord God, we ask that you move by your power, oh God. Move, Lord God, by your power, oh God. In the name of Jesus, send your anointing, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, every believer, oh God, under the sound of my voice, oh God, right now we ask that you have your way, Jesus. Have your way, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We come casting our cares at your feet, oh God. We cast all our cares, all our heavy burdens, oh God, for those who are going through sickness, Lord God, disease, oh God, for those who are heavy laden, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that are carrying burdens, oh God. Lord God, you said cast our cares upon you, for you care for us, oh God. Right now, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we cast our cares, oh God. Lord God, move by your healing power, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I lift the people of God to you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Asking you to have your way, to bless, oh God, to continue to keep them, oh God, to continue to sustain them, oh God, even in this season, oh God. Give them your peace, oh God. Lord God, we know that you have the final say, Lord God. So whatever we're going through, Lord God, when we cast our cares on you, you have the final say, oh God. We ask that you will move by your power, Lord God, like only you can, oh God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, heal sick bodies, oh God. What the doctor said couldn't be cured, Lord God. We know that you are a curable God, Lord God, that you have all healing in the hem of your garment, oh God, in the name of Jesus. So we cast our cares on you, oh God. Lord God, right now in the name of Jesus, every house that's represented here, oh God, in the name of Jesus, the families that are represented here at Greater Mount Olive Baptist Church, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, continue to hold them together, oh God. Continue to let your love abide, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. In this ministry, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. Show forth your glory, Lord God, and your power, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. Right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we just cast our cares on you, oh God. Speak to us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, speak to us, oh God. Show us the way that you would have us to go, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. And let us have the ears to hear your voice, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, bless the angel of this house, oh God. Lord God, as the task that he has set before him, oh God. In the name of Jesus, strengthen his body, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, let him continue to be able to stand and preach your word, Lord God, to a dying world. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, that souls may be saved, Lord God, that sinners may come to you asking, what must I do to be saved, oh God? In the name of Jesus, Lord God, anoint his hands, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Anoint his lips, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that whatever he speak, whatever he touch shall prosper, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that your people prosper, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, bless the word that's going to go forth, Lord God, power and conviction, oh God, that it change the hearts of your people, that it renews the mind and the spirit of your people, in the name of Jesus. Have your way in this place, oh God. Have your way in this place, oh God. Have your way in this place. Remind us that we can cast all our cares upon you, for you care for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Give God some praise. How many of you know that Jesus is real? Come
Praise the Lord, everybody. Right where you are, just begin to give God glory. He's worthy to be praised. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. We count it the honor and the privilege for this opportunity just to stand before you. So we give honor to Pastor Simmons. We give honor to Reverend James Simmons and to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. We're going to rush hurriedly to the word. Turn your Bibles with me to Psalms 145, and for your consideration, we're going to read verse 1 through 3 and verse 7 and 8. Shall we pray? Father God, we come before you right now, Lord God. We come first of all just to say thank you. Lord, we thank you for what has taken place in this service on today, Lord God. We thank you for your presence, oh God. We thank you for your glory in this place, oh God. Father God, we thank you for this chance and this opportunity just to worship you and give you praise, Lord God. Father God, we just ask that you just send the word on this morning, oh God, that will minister to our hearts, our minds, and our spirits. Open up our ears of understanding that we may receive from you, Lord God. Father God, let us not only hear this word, but let us apply it, oh God. Father God, let no flesh glory in thy sight, oh God. We ask that you forgive us of every sin and every shortcoming right now in the name of Jesus. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable unto you, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. These blessings we ask in Jesus' name, amen. In Psalms 145, verse 1 reads, I will extol thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. Verse 7 and 8 read, they shall abundantly utter the memory of thy great goodness and shall sing of thy righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great mercy. And I just want to talk for a few minutes on the topic, motivated to worship and to serve. And I want to pose this question to you this morning. What motivates you? For those of us that must go to a job each day, what motivates that? That's obvious. We have demands that are made upon us that we must meet. And because of getting up and going there every day, there is a reward called payday. What motivates you to make those trips to the doctor? Well, that's obvious. You want to stay as well as you can. You want to know what is going on with your body and what you might be able to do to live a healthier life. What motivates you to make those weekly trips to the beauty salon for your appointments or to your barber? Well, that's obvious because you want to look as best as you can. What motivates you to make those weekly trips to the grocery store? Well, that's obvious. You like to eat, and the grocery store has the nutrients that you want and need. Motivation is a powerful tool, isn't it? And as believers, one that says that we believe and realize that God is our source and our strength, and that life is the result of a loving and patient God, then that should be our motivation to be faithful unto God. What are the reasons that people of faith can just categorize the Lord's Day as just any other day as a believer? I understand why non-church people would do it and non-believers would do it, but it's baffling to me why the believers, the crowd, will make the Lord's Day such a trivial day. Why is it that believers must be pumped and primed to serve and to worship God? Again, I understand people who are not walking in the light, choosing not to serve and to commit. But how can people of faith do that? Perhaps it's a real lack of serious and committed motivation. And in our text, David gives us some reasons why we should be motivated to worship and to serve God. The first reason we should be motivated is because we realize the greatness of God. Verse 1 through 3 says, I will extol you, my God, O King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day will I bless you, and I will will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. And that should be motivation enough to give God glory because he is great. The greatness of God is independent of circumstances, situations, or seasons. When life is not great, the Lord of life is still great. Amen. He does not change with the wind of time. He does not lose his worth when the economy is bad. And he never has a power outage because of the storms in your life. He is not swayed by our situations. He is not swayed by our failings. And there are tests and trials in life that you and I must face. You need a great God to make it through. And he will give you the faith that you need to face the test. Amen. And the hymn writer says about him, great is thy faithfulness, because not only will he give us the faith that we need to face the test, but he's faithful unto us even when we are not faithful unto him. Amen. And when we as his children are less than and far below what we should be, he is still a great God. He is never reduced by our failures or our fears. He is never reduced by our shortcomings. He is never lesser because we are being less than what we should be. He is such a great God that he even looks beyond our faults and our failures. And every day I recognize that God is great. Amen. And the greatness of God is indefinable. He is a God without limits. When the Apostle Paul wrote to the church at Corinth, Paul's love and appreciation for Christ was at such an elevated level. Paul described him as the undefinable gift, the unspeakable gift. David in Psalms talks about the excellence of his name. And this greatness is also undefeatable. Pharaoh could not beat him. The Red Sea could not beat him. Our problems cannot beat him. Our trials cannot beat him. Amen. And the next reason why we should be motivated to worship is because we realize the goodness of our God. Amen. Verse 7 says, they shall abundantly utter the memory of thy great goodness and shall sing of thy righteousness. And let me pause right here for a second, because it always troubles me when I can go into a service and nobody is saying anything. Nobody is giving God glory. And this verse just told us that they shall abundantly utter the memory of thy goodness. And that means that when you think back on how good God has been to you, you ought to be saying something. And if you can sit in a service and never open your mouth, I challenge you today to check your memory. Next time you're sitting next to someone and it seems like they can't get into the service, just tell them to check their memory. The psalmist declares that I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. And when we think of God's goodness and his mercy, something should be coming out of our mouths. If you can sit in a service and not say thank you, Jesus, I dare you to check your memory. If you can sit in a service and not say, Lord, you're worthy, just check your memory. If you can sit and not say, Lord, I love you, check your memory. If you can sit and not say, hallelujah, check your memory. Because the writer declares that when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank God for saving me. So let's pause for a quick memory check. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Right in the comment section, right in your living room, right wherever you are, you ought to think back to where God has brought you from and give God some praise, because he's worthy. Amen. Hallelujah. The goodness of God is a natural attribute of God. He does not have to try to be good. He does not have to aim at being good. He is just good. good, amen. And his goodness is a constant goodness. He's good 24 hours a day. He's good 7 days a week. He's good 52 weeks a year. He's good 12 months of the year. He's good 365 days a year. And he's so good every second of the minute. He's good every minute of the hour. He's good every hour of the day. He's good in every season of the year. And he's good of regardless of who is in the White House, regardless of who the Attorney General is, or regardless of who is living in the governor's mansion. God is still good. Regardless of the stats of this pandemic or the looming threat of another shutdown, God is still good. No matter what we have lost along the way, no matter who we have lost along the way, God is still good. And the next thing about his goodness is it's a compassionate goodness. David says he's good and that his mercy meets us when we have made mistakes. Samson will say the same thing, but when we mess up and you have violated all of the rules, God is so good that he will allow the roots to grow back. Amen. When I think about worship and serving God, I want to do it because the Lord has been so good. Has he been good to anybody on today? He deserves our best because what he has given us. He deserves our best because he gave us the best that he had. He deserves our best because he gave us all that he had. And he desires our best because he wants to see how much we love him in return. Amen. The next reason we are motivated is because we rely on his graciousness. Verse 8 says, the Lord is gracious and he's full of compassion. He's slow to anger and of great mercy. And you would think that as believers, we would not need to be motivated by anything else to worship and to serve God. And these variables that Psalms 145 has deposited, in my opinion, should alone merit that. Not a building, not a charismatic preacher, not a large and good choir, not gifted and talented musicians, not a huge membership, but his greatness and his goodness motivates me. And for what Psalms 8 says, Psalms 145 and 8 says, and it that motivates me to worship him. Only and solely because of his grace. It's a grace that covers all of my needs. It's not a partial grace, but his grace is full. It's grace that you can lean on. It's grace that holds you up when you want to let go. It's grace that comforts you. And sometimes we get wounded along the way and we want to wallow in those wounds. But this grace can heal the wounds. This grace can be the salve that you pour into your wounds. It's grace that helps you to smile through your tears. It's grace that helps you to push through when you are tired. It's grace that helps you to get up from the ground and run on. It's grace that says it's not all right right now, but it will be all right after a while. It's grace that assures you that you are not alone. Where would we be without the grace of God? His grace has kept me. His grace has protected me. His grace has covered me. His grace has delivered me. His grace has brought me out. His grace saved me when I didn't deserve it. And you may ask how. The Bible declares that while we were yet sinners, Christ died. Oh, didn't he die? He died to cover. He died to save. He died to set free. And not only did he die, but he got up and he went into heaven and his grace and his mercy are still covering me today. Who wouldn't serve a God like this? The song says, amazing grace shall always be my song of praise, for it was grace that brought my liberty. I do not know just why he came to love me so, but he looked beyond, he looked beyond, he looked beyond my fault, and he saw my needs. I'm motivated to give God glory. I'm motivated to give him honor. I'm motivated to give him all of my worship, and I will serve him for the rest of my life. You don't have to pump me up. You don't have to prime me. I'll bless him because he's worthy. I'll bless him because he's good. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not his benefits. When I think about how he's blessed me, I'll give him worship. When I think about how he's kept me, I'll bless his name. When I think about how he's healed me, I'll bless him. When I think about how he provides for me, I'll bless him, because I'm motivated to give him worship. Anybody motivated today to serve the Lord? Anybody motivated to lift him up? Anybody motivated to give him praise? Come on and think about how he's brought you out. Think about how he made a way out of no way. Think about all the doors he's opened. Think about how he covered and protected. Think about how he kept you through this pandemic. And you ought to be motivated to give him praise. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast unto the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify, oh, magnify, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I'm motivated to worship and to serve the Lord. Come on, right where you are, give God praise. Peace.